I'm gonna be a world champion. I have to be. All the blood, sweat and tears, all the time is out with family, with friends. No way, 23, imagine 10 years. I'm only chasing greatness, nothing else. So just quickly, I wanted to give a quick shout out to CBD Secrets Garden. They don't sponsor me in anything or anything, but before my last fight, I hurt myself a little bit. And basically, the two owners are friends of my dad. It's an Austrian-Hungarian company. And when I had the injury, basically I called my dad up. They were together, and I was like, "Oh shit, I just hurt myself." And straight away, they sent me so much stuff, with from CBD drops to I got cooling cream, I got warm up cream, I got this like little thing that I put on my scar and stuff like that. So, but they've got everything. So just make sure you check them out, especially if you're hungry. But yeah, I just wanted to give them a little shout out as a thank you for the help they've provided me in my last camp. Now I've got Sinus coming in, who's a wrestler. He travels all over the world, wrestles everywhere, so we're going to do some wrestling together.
That's all right.
I appreciate that.
Even I don't have a Hungarian wrestler. You know what? I changed into it. Yeah, wrestling is. I changed into it. Probably a Hungarian.
Nice. Oh, nice. You're wearing that now.
Yeah, I'm wearing it now. I haven't worn these since I was like fucking 10.
Peanut butter school.
Huh?
Peanut butter school.
Oh, you don't like it?
No, it's hot.
It's fucking hot. That's what I was thinking. Wait, how do you
go? I'm gonna press it over. One time over this
time.
Basically, because of my granddad won the Olympics in 1980.
Okay, did he?
Yeah.
What, freestyle?
Yeah, freestyle, but 50 kilos or 48 okay, kilos, nice. So he was small. And then he came to England to fix Persian carpets, and then they tried to represent England in 1984.
Yeah.
They wouldn't sign for his passport, because the guy he was beating every time, they wanted him to go. And then from then till now, it's just been the same political stuff. You know what I mean?
Listen, they fucked my dad or my granddad over. Like, my granddad was on his way to Olympics, yeah, like 96 something. They stopped him at the airport and did take him out for another one. Then, well, they took 1980, they took my dad out.
Right.
But then after that, they didn't take him out for one Olympic, 1984. And then after that, when it was special with us, in 1990 something, they left him at the play, they fucked him over. It's always like that, it's a bunch of idiots. But it's so sad, man. You're working so hard, you're doing so well.
I've got to say, you know, and it's funny because in Hungary, everyone knows who you are. That's how I got into contact with you. Yeah. They kept telling me about your dad and how now you've gone into MMA because you didn't want to go through what your dad went through.
No, man, it's interesting. Outrageous.
You know? But it's the same. Like, it's funny. Like, because my coach is from Hungary, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be where I am now. Because England wasn't letting me represent them, he took me under as Hungary. I wasn't for Europe for Hungary, not for
Europe. I mean, listen, this guy, he travels all the time, goes everywhere just to get his fucking name up and to get those medals and everything. And the fact that people are fucking him over, just politics and everything, man. It's so sad.
It's bad, but like, it doesn't change anything, you know. Like, the result will still remain the same. It's just going to take a little bit longer than what I obviously hoped for, you know. Like, I wanted to age well. Thank you. I appreciate it.
I can't rush it. I know I've got so much to work on, and the division is full of killers. I mean, what Johnny Eblen did last time, like his last fight, was amazing. I have to get ready for that stuff. But I am coming. You know, I just want all these middleweights to know that while they're doing their weights and their fat session, I'm putting in live work. Nothing in this world annoys me more that someone might be better than me. For me to outwork these guys, it's easy. But my skills have to be better. I'm still young, I need to get stronger. I wrestle with elite guys. I wrestle with, I do jits with literally the number five ranked guy in the world, you know. No, listen, I've been wrestling since I was, you know, three and a half. So I've got videos of me as a kid wrestling. I can wrestle. If I live a fight life. You know, all these guys, I'll go home, you know, my girlfriend, my this and that. No, I spend 10 hours at the gym. I don't have, my family's away from me. I don't have nothing else in my life but fighting. I live a fight life. And I think that's one of the biggest differences between me and a lot of the other fighters.
One more, three. Yeah.
No way I'm not going to be a world champion. No way.
You can say that twice.
No way we're not going to be world champion.
Definitely no way.
Yeah. So no way I'm not going to be a world champion. Fucking, I'm at the gym all day, every day. I spar wrestlers, boxers, MMA fighters, just guys. I do all the work. All the work. Yeah. All these Johnny Evans, all these Adesanya's, Alex Pereira's, they're so good. They're so good, but they're humans. And I'm going to outwork them. And no way, no way anyone else is outworking me. They have to be superhuman. And other than me, I haven't met a lot of them. But I'm going to be a world champion. I have to be. All the blood, sweat and tears, all the time is out with family, with friends. No way, 23. Imagine 10 years. I'm only chasing greatness, nothing else.
They'll have to get an army to a beat you, man.
Huh?
They'll have to get an army to a beat you.
Wow, hold me. Fuck, thank you so much.
No, thank you. I wrestled for like 21 years, and like when I did get to your leg, just couldn't finish at all. Like it made no sense because, like I said, you don't really. I mean, obviously you have your dad, but you're not an actual wrestler. So it doesn't make sense. Like if I went into boxing, if you're like your time in MMA against like a world champion, former world champion boxer, I'd be getting my ass kicked.
But that's what I mean. Like that's what we do. I mean, Alex is our head coach. He's he's got WBC heavyweight world champion boxing. Yeah. Mm. He's got ABCC finalist. He's main event and every MMA show in the world.
Yeah.
And qualified for wrestling Olympics. Yeah. There's just one guy. He's got so much knowledge. That's what I mean. It's good for you if you come down as well.
No, definitely. But I'm still trying to say in general, like, I'm a pure wrestler.
Yeah.
Like, I wrestled since I was 5.
Yeah.
You haven't wrestled anywhere near as long as I have, and you've stuffed 95% of the technique I did today. Bro, that's not normal. Like that's definitely not normal at all. And remember, I wrestled like all over the fucking world. So I wrestled against some of the best guys, and I go to North London and I get my ass kicked.
Thank you, man. No, it's great work. I really fucking enjoyed it.
No, I appreciate you as well, man.
We'll do more of this 100%. And as I said, I want to share your story as well, so we're going to put that on. I find it a mistake that someone who just puts so much time into something and all the money and sweat and all the blood, sweat and tears into sport they love, it's what they're not allowed to do what they love. Do you get what I mean?
Yeah. So, I thought there'll be two world champions in this gym, you know?
Yeah,
so, yeah. Thank you. I appreciate it.
I appreciate it. Alright, let's grab some Nigerian food now.
Performance still after every training session. I mean, these guys have been looking after me so much and they're so good. They are so good. And all the marketing stuff aside, they're great. So they actually formulate all this stuff on recovery. So I can only recommend that. They're amazing.
We're out here now. I'm going to try some Nigerian food. I've never tried it before, so hopefully I'm going to like it. And then these guys are going to put me on what to eat and do and stuff like that. So yeah, let's go.
I think you'll like Lucy, but it's fattening. It's very.
No, yeah.
Timon, is your cutting's over now, aren't
you? I think you might like some lamb shoe, yeah. I think you might like that.
I think I should get the Obono as well.
Yeah, I think it's
good. What are you getting?
Me?
I might get Obono.
I'm going to get best.
I'm the only white person.
Yeah, you should get. Yeah, he is. So, I think you should get white rice.
Give me all the heat now. Actually, I'm not the only one. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm good.
Brother!
We just asked you just going to say no.
We just watch. Yeah, for my friend.
I'm white rice.
Yeah.
Bro, I bring Nigerians to a Nigerian restaurant, they don't even know what they want.
Like, I just know what my mum makes me, to be
honest.
So my
new
5
chicken wings?
Yeah.
5 chicken wings.
Yeah?
How can I get mild, please?
He runs like Phoebe. That's like Phoebe from Friends.
You want none of this?
Yeah? Square him up, let's go.
What's it from state?
Yeah.
What are you expecting?
Thank you, Dad.
And now you can see why music classes go there. He learned from his childhood in Africa.
I knew he was gonna go there.
That's great, yeah.
Motto's up on you.
It's gonna be good, it's alright, it's not hot. It's gonna be hot, innit?
No, it's not.
If it's mild, it shouldn't be that bad.
Nah, it's good. It's actually tastes very similar to Hungarian food. I swear down. Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Sort of similar.
Yeah, dip it in some of the sauce.
I was about to say, it's pretty hot. This one as well. This one's pretty hot. This one's pretty hot too.
Is it actually pretty hot?
Uh-huh. I don't think that's hard to melt. They probably made the stew already. Like, how are they going to melt it though?
Probably put ice cubes in it or
something. Why are you eyeing me for? Why is everyone staring at me? Everyone's staring at me. I'm looking around. Everyone's staring at me. What's up? It's alright.
How much should I like take out?
Whatever you can swallow, of course.
Hey, big guy,
but it's true though. Hey,
alright, we get it. You got a big dick, alright.
Come on, true. Your phone went off. Yeah, no, that's too small, brother.
Yeah. Why are you looking at these guys going camera off me? What the fuck?
Your first bite. I told you this already. How is it?
Nice. Well, eat again though.
Why are you filming, bro? Like, shit.
I didn't believe you, man. Eat again then.
Yeah.
Take another one, dude. What I like to roll it into like a semi-perfect circle. Even dash it into the air, let it aerate a little bit.
Yeah, the pounded yam that's getting me off so much.
You can share this with anyways.
Yeah. The fufu. For the fufu. Right? The fufu.
What is fufu yam as well? Is fufu yam as well?
Yeah, it's fufu.
I'm saying proud, sure.
What?
Emily in Paris. Bang.
What the fuck is that?
Emily in Paris. It's the dumbest show, but the funniest.
But you need that switch off.
Bro, that's what I'm saying.
It's not every day trying to listen to
that. Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
The next one. Oh, come on. I've not seen that. The whole thing.
Nine-Nine.
Do you know what?
Nine-Nine.
Who's your favorite coach?
No, so. He's one of the kids at the gym. He's like 13 years old.
Logan.
Yeah, Logan. He got in a little trouble at school. And then it was like, actually, I need to do something with myself. And yeah, he started his own clothing brand. So, and it's really good. So make sure, ignore this. I just can't eat properly. But make sure you check out Youngest because they're some good stuff.
They've
got some good stuff.
You know who smashes that? Makes that probably one of the best stand-up things I've heard in many years. Marlon Wayans just came back. Marlon Wayans just came back and stand up. He hasn't done it in 20 years and he explains on this thing why. And it's so personal to him, he ruins, he goes off to everybody. But I mean like, with regards to the same scenario. If Will Smith thinks he would be angry at Chris Rockstar, he'd die listening to Marlon Wayans.
I say all the time, the Wayans brothers are the most underrated comedians.
Yeah,
the Wayans brothers
are
the
best.
They're so good.
I'm fucking so tired. Trust me.
Ready to sleep.
Yeah.